The earth survives, humanity survives. Humanity survives, earth survives. For me to be conferred the award of laureate or accolade of champion of earth is an honor and privilege, actually. But at the same time, it cast a huge duty. And I will have to continue on a bigger scale and then create awareness about marine litter so that people don't litter plastic, balloons, water bottles onto the beach and into the water bodies all over. We have around 1.5 billion people in India. And imagine if you have two hands and if everybody gets onto the job, what a change it can be. I would like to see all coastal communities taken up. It can be a big, big, big example for the world in terms of what two hands can do.
Thank you very much, first of all, for coming and inspiring us with your wonderful words. We have read about social changes and causes in textbooks and through data and analysis and graphs. But you, sir, you have given us a first-hand experience about something we've only seen in TV or we've read. So in this experience of about 76 weeks, what do you think motivates people to get out of their houses, identify problems and then help solve it?
First of all, thank you very much for having me. That's in my design. Thank you, Dr. Koshi. Thank you all, the management here. And thank you for your wonderful founder, Sara, Mathew. I feel when I read about her, it's like I'm on the same journey as her, in which you call the road less traveled. But I want that phrase to change. It must become the road more traveled, so that more human beings travel. Coming back to your question, you have said what motivates them, it's in two parts. See, the first part is the initial jump, whether to do it or not to do it, how should I do it. Once that happens, there's a flow of energy, adrenaline, love there. And I say that from my experience. Once you come and pick up so much plastic and muck, something changes in your head. It changed me as a lawyer, it changed me as a human being, it changed me as a person who I was. Once you start doing the change happening, to come on the lighter side, happiness, love, it's all great. The flip side is, become fitter by cleaning the beach. We all have become fitter. People who are going to the gym, I advise them, freehand squats happening at the beach, up, down, up, down. So, people who in Bombay want to pay thousands of rupees for gym, I tell them, come, do this gym, you'll get fitter. All of us have got fitter, we have lost orders of weight, looking fit. So that's all the journey. It's fun, love, sharing, giving. No, but I don't want to intellectualize it. There's not too much of a deep thought process that's come to it.
You said in your speech that education is a constitutional right. And it is generally assumed that education is a primary tool.
Yeah.
And considering that your locality is inherited by the educated class, what took them so long?
I'll tell you, the word education is very subjective to my mind. Some people may use the word subject education in terms of going to a school, going to a college. Some people may take it in the term of they learn from your mother, whatever. It's very subjective. What our constitution says is formal education. Let me clarify. Formal education. You go to a school, you go to a college, you do this, get your degree in your hand, so you are ready for the next step to get a job. In that capacity, when you see people around, they may be formally educated, but they may not be educated in that sense to handle the environment. There's a difference between formally educated and being educated enough to understand the wisdom of the problem. And once you get educated, my hatred was, see, nobody picked up garbage in Mumbai. Forget about being a lawyer, nobody did. Not even this one person did it. And then the whole question was, it was a mindset change. In the 70 years it has happened. So you expect things not to turn. I am a very patient man and I want to be patient. I tell people that I will, even if none of my volunteers are there, I will be alone cleaning, no matter what, because it's a personal journey, I will stand. And all my life, till physically, my physicality doesn't permit me to. But I'll be doing it because that's all I can do for my planet and for my ocean and for marine species.
For this cause, there was definitely financial hurdles you must have faced. What were they?
Well, there's no financial hurdle. See, I do not ask for money. I'm very clear about it. I have not raised a single rupee from anybody. My slogan is this: my time, my effort, my money. So I give my time, my effort and my money. A lot of people write to me from Europe, America, God knows, saying that, can we give you money? I say, no, don't give me money. I am not some caretaker of your environment. You become the caretaker of your environment. Say for example, I need a JCB at my beach, a machine which cleans. I have 10,000 rupees, so I said, take the man to the operator and clean it for me. I tell people, anybody who feels the need, do it yourself. This whole idea of passing on the baton to others and the money to others doesn't work. 70 years the environment has not improved, that means there is something drastically wrong. Why are my oceans not clean? Why are my beaches not clean? Why are the marine species suffering? There is something drastically wrong. Too many laws, too many policies, too many complications, too many... The narrative must be, go to that individual. You start doing it. Don't wait for everybody. Talk. Start with your house. Then take it on to your environment. Then provoke others to do it. So that's how it works. So no money involvement at all. And I want to say that, you know, we volunteers must stay away from money and power. These two things can corrupt. And that's why I never want to get into politics or power or raising money. I said, you know, a lot of people tell me, we'll give you JC. They say, tumhare paas hi rakho aur saaf karo. Tum hi leke aao saaf karne ke liye. Main kyun aao? Aapka kaam aap karo. Humko mat bol do.
So the Prime Minister mentioned you in his Mann Ki Baat talk on the radio. In your opinion, how successful are these on-paper government initiatives like Swachh Bharat Abhiyan?
Your question has two aspects. What do you feel about the Prime Minister mentioning and what do you feel about the Swachh Bharat? To come to the first question, see the Prime Minister mentioning, of course we feel great. Thank you, Prime Minister. I've thanked him on Twitter, Facebook, personally. But for me, it's my every next Saturday Sunday. See, these are all consequences. I did not start it for the Prime Minister. I did not start for the UN. I started for myself. So for me, you know, in my head when I'm talking to you, my tomorrow's cleaning program is running in my head. Of how will I land at the beach, how will I start cleaning, how should the garbage move out. So for me, that's that. These are all consequences. They may come, they may not come. Even if it hadn't come, I would still be doing what I'm doing. So that's to your first question. Now to your second question about Swachh Bharat. See, I have no access to any data, factual or otherwise, to comment on it. If some data comes to me, what I'm as naive or as good as you are, who are watching on TV, what's going on, so no comment on that. I can't comment on Swachh Bharat because I have no access, no personal knowledge of things. If I do, I do. At least to tell you, at least, you know, the fact that the Prime Minister from Delhi not only spoke on Mann Ki Baat, he's taken it one step forward, which I'm lacking with. The Minister of Environment is, I had a meeting with them 3-4 days back here in Delhi, and they are gearing up to clean beaches. 13 beaches are earmarked all over Mumbai, all over India. I have to drop the plan. That means the government is moving, but, you know, to add a caveat to it, I don't know how it will happen, what will happen. I'm as clueless as you are. So only time will tell what will happen. I don't want to boast about with the government coming on and miracles will happen. Because finally, you know, we citizens led it. We got the government on board. Everybody's working hard. That same model will have to be replicated. Results, I don't know. I can't tell.
So how do you check for the intentions of your volunteers? I mean, are they doing it for popularity and to join the bandwagon? Or is it actually the love for the environment?
See, for me, intention is immaterial. I tell people, just come, join, clip and go.
Yeah.
You know, work for 2 hours, have fun. If they want to clip pictures, put it on Facebook, I tell them. So, there's nothing to it. The intentions are immaterial, people are cleaning. The only thing I'm really cautious about political parties, you know. Congress, BJP, in Mumbai, Shiv Sena, MNS, they all come to clean with me. And I tell them, you wear a dual hat. Remove the hat of the political party, wear the hat of citizens. And let the citizen talk about it. Finally, whether an individual will vote for A, B, C, D, will depend on his stake of what he feels good governance is. But at least with this moment, where a citizen's hat, I tell people. It's a non-political movement, it should continue like this.
Thank you very much, sir. It was
my pleasure.
Great talking to you.
Thank you. Pleasure. Thanks.